Hello and welcome to another episode of Do Crafts TV. Today we're going to be joined by Lou Collins, who's going to show us a stunning scrapbook page using the Papermania Heritage Press collection and showing us that it's not just for Father's Day. Hi Lou, welcome along.
Hi Katie.
So you're going to show us a scrapbook page today.
Yes, my favourite. I love scrapbooking.
Oh, me too. So you've used the Heritage Press collection.
Heritage Press, New of the Artiste spritzing inks.
Fantastic. I know they're a favourite of yours as well.
Different ways of using them as well.
Wonderful.
Well, first I'm going to use papers from the Heritage Press collection. Now, these are shown on my scrapbook page, but this is one that I thought I probably wouldn't use on this layout.
Okay.
So I'm actually using the reverse of it because it's quite a smooth paper. So we're going to die cut it first because what I want to do is eventually get this faux metal effect.
Okay.
So we're going to use these two. So what I'm going to do is lay these down. We can do both of these
just
at the same time.
Just popping those on top of the plate, aren't we there?
Yes. And we'll pop our paper on top.
There we go. Lovely.
Run this through.
So you've got this just under sort of 4.5, haven't you, about?
I'm just going to pull it up slightly because it's very thin paper.
Yeah.
So it doesn't need to go through.
You sometimes find you need a little bit more depth with more detailed dies as well, don't you?
Yes.
The ones that are quite simple, you can have it, you can back it off a little bit.
Yeah. Pop them out. Really easy, lovely cut on
those.
That's
brilliant, isn't it?
So you can just hold those
clean
for me
cut,
a second.
No problem.
So next we're going to add the colour. This is where we start to get our mottled old metal effect. So we're going to add this one first. Hematite.
Oh, whatever you like.
But it's got
it's
this
a sort
beautiful.
Of
it's got this beautiful sort of sort of grey shimmer mica in it.
Yeah.
So what I'm doing is I'm shaking. I'm not shaking it up and down because some of that will go up into the nozzle and it could cause a blockage.
Oh, okay.
So you shake
it side to side
and you can hear it in there. So if you can lay the circles white side up for me.
There you go.
You want to spray from a distance. So that's all we need. We don't need any more than
just
that.
Just a really light spritz there.
So now I've got the Artiste ink pad. It's the dye ink pad and it's dark orange.
Lovely. And you've got your stamp pad foam, haven't you, there, which is really good for applying inks.
Oh, it's brilliant. You cut it to size, shape. I mean, you can cut this to a real point.
Yeah.
Use it. But can you see, as I'm rubbing it in, I'm actually rubbing it off of the mat.
Yeah.
But it's not covering up that ink, so you've got that speckled effect
in
there. So now I've done that. What I'm going to do a second time is add a little bit more ink. Like I say, you can see that shimmer in there, which gives
really
it the metal effect.
Really catches the light, that, doesn't it?
And we're now going to emboss this beautiful, I think it's a bit like a metal grill or a metal...
It does, yeah.
A metal tray, so
yeah,
I'm going
it really
to use...
does. It's like a manhole cover sort of effect, isn't it? Yeah.
So it just adds to that metal effect. So
bring him back in.
Anything bigger than this circle won't fit in the embossing folder.
Okay, so yeah, so we've done all the detail on it first. Now we're popping it in there.
Yeah, we'll just run this through. You can really feel it going through, so you know it's going to have a lovely impression on it. It comes out. There we go, there's the second
one. Wow, it really sort of makes the shiny areas really pop, doesn't it?
I'm just going to pick out some of that embossing. You can use the same sponge, but I'm going to use black ink. Only a small amount, a really small amount. And just brush it over. Can you see? It's picking it up.
Adds to those raised areas.
Yeah. I'm just going to add this black ink around the edges as well. And this just helps lift it up from the page, almost adds a shadow around it once it's on your layout page.
Yeah.
So now we're going to go onto our layout page. So first I'm just going to do a light spritz over, so we've still got the speckles.
Lovely.
And take a bit of kitchen roll, this is preparation so I don't make a mess. I'm lifting the lid up. And what I'm doing, I'm going to plan roughly where these two metal pieces are going, because what I want to do is add some drips down, almost oil dripping down from them.
So you're positioning them so you know that it's sort of going to come from behind.
Yeah, so I've got a pencil here and I'm just going to very lightly do a line from the bottom of these. It's only roughly.
Yeah.
So you've got an idea. Once you take it away, you've got an idea of where you want to put these. So what I'm doing now is I'm going to very carefully depress the nozzle, not enough for it to squirt out. And then the magic. I'll try and do this away from me. you can see, and we'll turn it upside up. And it dries ever so quickly, so you've not got fast running.
Yeah, it's not running
drips,
all the way off the page.
No, so you can control it a bit more. And we can just add to it. There we go.
That looks lovely.
And as soon as you're at the stage where you don't want it to go down anymore, just lay it flat.
And you can see already that it's drying,
going to just whiz it very quickly, because when I do the other circle, I don't want these to drip any further.
Sure. Brilliant.
That's just enough, so there's no excess.
There's no
to run
really
down.
Sort of pooled sections no. there.
I'm going to do the same the other side. That was lucky that actually fell in the right place.
I suppose the wonderful thing about this is that there's no mistakes really, is there? Because it's designed to look
sort there's
of
not,
random, isn't it?
Also, every page will be original. You'll never have one exactly
no,
the same.
No, that's lovely.
You can't control it quite enough. Just to add a slight patina look to the whole page, to the metal, I'm going to add, that's hot.
Ooh.
I'm going to add some green just behind where the circles will be.
Okay.
So you won't see a lot of those.
Okay.
There'll be bits peeking through. Right, so while that's drying, what I'm going to do is die cut. So what we'll do, blade to the paper, position these where we're going to like want them. There we go. So I'll now lift it so that our blades will be touching the cutting mat.
Yeah, you always want to cut into your cutting pads, unsurprisingly.
We're just running that through around about number 5. Go through twice. Forward and back just to make sure it's cut through properly.
Perfect.
So there we have a perfect circle shape.
Wonderful.
What I'll do is I'll pop him.
Oh no!
Yep, cut him in
oh,
half.
Oh my word!
Okay, so we can start building our page up now. So I've got my two metal pieces.
Lovely.
Going to go there. And start positioning. I've got a larger circle. What I'm going to actually do is add a bit of the brown ink to the edges of these to match.
Okay, yeah.
Again, like the black ink on here, that will help lift it off the page. And it doesn't matter, I've still got a bit of black on there. It really doesn't matter at all. There we go. So if you lay your photo on, just start positioning.
This is a really good trick for scrapbooking, isn't it? That if you sort of worry about where you're going to put things and...
Don't stick it down.
Yeah, just keep, you know, just not stick anything down to start with and just arrange all the bits and pieces where you want them.
There we go. So they'll be like that. So what I would do now if I was at home is take a photo of that with my phone or something.
Very good.
Just so I remember exactly where it's going to go. So here's one of our pieces. I'm going to pop that... around here.
Oh, that's very clever.
I should have another one under here. That one will go. With the Heritage Press papers, you can also buy die cut packs.
Ah, yes.
And this sheet is from one of them.
So there's a wonderful decoupage sets, aren't they, that have got sort of lovely
beautiful.
Suits and little shirts and so on. But yeah, like you said, these are the sentiments that come along. You always get loads spare, don't you?
So. Loads and loads spare. So I'm going to use some that I probably wouldn't you'd be able to use twice, because you get two sheets of this in a pack. So there's my 100%. Again,
oh, I see. So it's just one of the tiny little elements. Yeah. That's amazing.
So we've popped, where have I popped him? Him in there.
That looks great.
There we go. So
that's
I'm
beautiful.
Just going to glue all this down.
Yeah.
And then we'll start on the stamping and
brilliant.
The title.
Fantastic.
There we go.
That looks brilliant.
You can see I haven't glued my photo down. I want to do a little bit of lift with that with foam pads anyway.
Okay.
But also, on my page, I've added a little bit of detail with some twine.
Oh, I do like baker's twine.
I love it. This one is from the Capsule Collection, these Spots and Stripes.
Oh, yes.
Brights, I think. So I'm going to wrap this round twice. Tie it at the front and then manoeuvre it slightly to exactly where I want it to be. Moving that about now, what I've done is I've already popped my foam pads on the back here.
Oh, yes.
So I can just take these off, pop him there.
Lovely.
His 100% is going there. Now, my title.
Good stuff.
What I've done is I wasn't sure what letters to use with this. So I've altered some a little bit.
Ah, that's
these are
good.
Some that I've had for a little while. So what I've done is I've used the brown, just blending it as we said before, gently blending it into the top.
Now I see.
Now I'm going to use a different colour. I'm going to use the black. I'm going to use the black along with a bit of brown, okay, so it's not too harsh.
It's giving you that sort of really sort of on-trend ombre look, isn't it? That looks,
yes,
great.
So these are the dies that I cut my circles out of. Because, okay, I want to put my title here, I'm going to use this die. Just position the tops of them.
Oh, wow.
Only the very tops, just enough to hold them in place. There we go.
Perfect. That's a very clever trick. I'm definitely going to be stealing that one.
There we go. So there's another way of using the dies.
Brilliant.
So I'll just add a few buttons and that'll be the page finished.
Wonderful. Brilliant.
Very lastly, little timepiece that's come from the stamp
set. Yeah, this is the Heritage Press suit stamp set. Let's see what it's called. It's called Dapper Gent. Very nice.
Very dapper.
And obviously you've got all the parts to make a little suit, haven't you, here? So, but you've, yeah, also got the accents, like you said. The, so there's like a
there's
pipe.
There's a pocket watch, so I'm using this one today. Just one down here.
Brilliant.
There we go.
Lovely. It's got a really lovely flow across your page as well, sort of draws your eye down.
That's what you want
down
to do, is, yeah, let the eye trail down from, yeah, one side to the other.
Wonderful. Well, that's fantastic. Thank you so much, okay, for showing us that. It's lovely to see some scrapbooking. Wonderful. If you've enjoyed looking at Lou's project, we can find all the instructions for everything she's used, all of the products she's used and so on at docrafts.com. So pop over and have a little look, and you can create your own page. We'd also love to see if you've been crafting too. Perhaps you've been making some masculine projects. We'd love to see maybe what you gave as a card for Father's Day. Upload your projects to docrafts.com and then drop us a link in an email to tv@docrafts.com and we can feature your project on a future episode of Do Crafts TV. But until next time, happy crafting.